we have seen here that we have calculated zone 1 setting is 1.4 ohm and time delay is 1 second. Time for zone 2, that is 100%, we have taken the value we have got is 2 ohm and the time delay is 2 second. So we have completed the setting calculation of the impedance protection of the generator. For the time settings, it shall be coordinated at site with generator and generator transformer LV phase fault protection. So during calculation of time, and it is very much dependent upon the fault level of the system. So accordingly, it is being changed at the site, but the fundamental is same. You can calculate in that basis. Now we have under voltage. Under voltage relay, like how do we calculate the under voltage setting protection? Since we have PT ratio 16500 by root 3, 110 by root 3, so we have to set this value with reference to the secondary value. Our set VT secondary is 110 volt. Normally we take the under voltage setting, that is recommended is 70% of VT secondary. So if we will calculate 110 into 0.7, that means it will come around 77 volt. So we have to put this 77 volt in the relay in order to get the under voltage setting operated. And we have also time delay is 0 second. So here in this setting calculations, they have considered the 0 seconds, that is instantaneous. If voltage drop will happen, that on 77 voltage, it will take 0 second to trip the system on under voltage system. The third protection we are going to calculate is generator reverse power protection. G1 G2 for stage 1 and stage 2, like we can say G1 G2. So generator, generally it is calculated, recommended value is 0.5% of rated power. So our rated power is, you can see, 250 megawatt. Rated power 250 megawatt. That means 250, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 watt. We have calculated in watt. Now what will be the 0.5% of power? 0.5 by 100 into 250, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 watt, and if you will calculate, the value will like that, 125, 1, 2, 3, 4 watt. 0.5% of power will be like that, 125 watt. Now if we cannot put this setting in the relay, 125, we have to calculate with reference to the CT and PT. So 0.5% power referred to relay, that means 125 into 0.5, with respect to secondary we have to calculate is 1 to 1 to 500 into PT ratio 110 by root 3 divided 16500 by root 3, and if you will calculate the value, it will come, I have already calculated, is 3.34 watt. So with refer to
the relay, this value will come 3.34 watt. Now magnitude we have calculated is 3.34 watt. And what will be the time delay? Here two time delay is there. T1 is with turbine trip. In case reverse power occurred, we can trip the turbine, or we can also not trip the turbine. So we have two setting for time setting without turbine trip. So here for this particular generator, we have considered 2 second and 10 second without turbine trip. If our rated power will reach 3.34 megawatt in the relay, so it relay will watch up to 2 second, then it will give a trip command to the turbine with, so this two time turbine is logically they takes from logic, they either trip, they can trip the turbine or they cannot trip the turbine. Our next protection is generator low forward power. Here it was reverse, now it is low forward power. If our generator is has reached up to a minimum power, then the turbine trips, or might not be trips, either it comes on home load. So the setting calculation will remain same, like 0.5% of rated power. We have calculated that the rated power is 250123456 watt. So 0.5 by 100, the setting will be, setting calculation will be same as reverse power. So here we will get 12 watt, and 0.5% refer to relay, 1 to 5, 1 to 3, 4 into 5 by 1 to 5 double 0 CT ratio, and this is PT ratio. So the value the same, we have calculated 3.3 watt. So relay will read this 3.3 watt as 5% of rated power. So in that same case, we have two time delay. T1 with turbine trip, and T2 without turbine trip is 2 second, and here 10 second. Both are same, the difference is only the reverse power element will sense that reverse power, that means your generator will start moving in motor mode. That means your generator will become now motor, from supplying power to it will start taking power from the system. And this is low forward power, in case anything happens in the grid, or for maintaining the frequency you have downward the load, you have decreased the load up to that value, then your generator will trip on low forward power. Now we have generator field failure protection 40 G1 G2. So we are not going into what is the generator field failure protections, we will cover in other parts. If we are considering that, you will already know the concepts of generator field power protections and every protections. If you will be required, then just please comment. I will sure make a video in detail, like what are the generator field failure protection, how it works. So in this video, we are only concentrating on calculating the parameters, like how does it get calculated and how we set the parameters in the relay. So here we will calculate base impedance of generator. Base impedance of generator is KVA square by MVA ohm, and it will be 16.5 square
by 294. If you remember the parameter that we have 16.5 kV and ABA is 294 MVA. So if you will calculate the value will reach to 296 ohm. The value is 0.96 ohm. Now value of impedance refer to CT and PT. Now value of impedance refer to CT PT is 0.926 CT ratio by PT ratio. CT ratio 1 to 500, 5 into PT ratio. CT ratio by PT ratio. Here we have multiplied this by 16500 by root 3. Refer to CT PT. If you will calculate, the value will come to 144 ohm. This is the value. Now if you remember the transient reactance of the generator, saturated transient reactance of the generator, XD is 22.8%. so transient reactance of generator XD dash is 22.8%. so the value will come like 22.8 divided by 100 into 15.44, and the value will come 3.52 ohm. This is transient reactance in ohm. Now the synchronous reactance. XD. If you remember, our XD is 158%. 158%. So XD in ohm will come 158 by 100 into our value, that 15.454%, this value 15.54%. so we have multiplied 24.4 ohm. It comes is 24.4 ohm. So after that we calculate the offset setting. Offset setting is 0.5 of XD dash ohm. If we multiply 0.5 into XD dash, the value of XD dash was 3.52. It will come 1.76 ohm. And the circle diameter is XD ohm. The value we have got here is 24 ohm. 24 ohm will be your circle diameter. So in the relay settings, you will have like FFL XA1 that you have to set is like 0.5 into XD dash, and FFL 1XB1, the parameter will be XD. So 0.5 into XD that you have calculated, and this one is XD. So and the time delay will be, you have to set accordingly. Here it is 2 second. If you will go deep in this setting protection calculation, you can see like how it works, like how offsets and circle diameter works. But here we have just calculated the settings. So in that way you can calculate the setting of field failure protections. Now we have generator negative sequence. Sequence protection 46 G1 G2. So here we have maximum continuous phase 8%. You can see here 8%, and maximum scalarity is 10, is as per the generator data. So
which set I2 greater than one current set. We normally take the 65% of this 8/100 into, we have full load current of generator is 10292 ampere with respect to city primary 1250 ampere, and it will come as 0.043 ampere. And the time delay is 2 seconds. Now I2 greater than 2 current setting, we have two stage protection for the negative phase sequence is 8%, that means 8/100 into we have current 10292 1250. So the value will come 0.066 ampere. And we have another settings, I2 greater than 2 thermal capability constant. Thermal capability constant K heating is 10 into, since we have I square 10 I square, we have to calculate 10292 divided by 12500 square. So the value will come 6.78. So the recommended setting will be for I2 thermal greater than 1, first stage is 0.43 ampere, time delay 2 seconds. I2 to thermal we have setting 0.006 ampere and that we don't have time delay for this. This is instantaneous, and I2 thermal is 6.78 we will set. So if you will go in the relay, MICOM relay, generator protection relay, so you can see what are the parameters like I2 2 and I2 2 greater than thermal capability constant, like why these are being calculated and why we are putting into the relay, like how this helpful in calculating these things. You can go and refer to the manual. Now we have generator, dead machine protection. Generator dead machine protection is like you have inadvertent energized the system. Suppose in any condition our generator breaker get closed, so without synchronizing the generator, or in any case if generator started, then there is another protection like generator dead machine protections. So for these protections we take the current and voltage settings. How we do calculate the current settings and voltage settings? So generator current is 10292 ampere, and if we calculate, refer to the secondary, 10292 into 51250, in secondary it will come 4.12 ampere. The 10292, since 12500 is primary, a secondary is referred as 5 ampere, so if we will calculate for 10292 ampere, it will come 4.12 ampere. So however, relay is set at 10% of full load current of generator, as the element will not be enabled during normal operation of machine. So we generally calculate the current for dead machine is 4.1 to 10%. So generally it will come 412 ampere, and the voltage setting is 77 volt. Since under voltage setting is 77 volt, so it is 77 volt. We have also time delay is 1 second. So generally in this protection it senses the voltage and current. If this no voltage and current is up to 10% of the full load, then after one second the generator will trip on generator dead machine protection. The next protection is generator over voltage protection 59 G1. So generally our secondary voltage is 110 volt. So we take stage 1 as 105% of 110 volt, which will roughly come around 1.15.5 volt, and we have time delay is 2 second. And for stage 2, which will be instantaneous, we take the percentage like 140% normally. So the value will be around 154 volt, and the time delay is 0 since it is instantaneous. So this is very simple calculation of generator over voltage protection. We have another protection like under frequency protection. Since if you are generating mode, then you have, and your generator is connected with the grid, so you have to maintain a proper frequency, like it should not be under or it should not be over. It is 81 GUF. So normally for stage 2, stage 1 is 48.5 hertz, and time delay is 2.5 second, and stage 2 is 47.5 hertz, or time delay is 2 second. So you have to run the machine within this 50 hertz, lower you can go up to 47.5 48.5. these are stage 1 and stage 2. Why stage 1 and stage 2? Stage 1 will indicate alarm, and stage 2 will be trip. It will give alarm that your machine is under frequency, so maintain your frequency, either decrease the load maintain the frequency. And stage 2 is for trip, it will get trip. And similarly we have over frequency protection, like over frequency protection 81 GUF, over frequency protection. It is stage 1 is 50.5 hertz, time delay 1 second, that is alarm. And stage 2 is 51.5 hertz, and delay 2 second. So you have to run the machine within this frequency range, then your machine will be safe.